Howdy folks, and welcome back once more. Let's play Legend of Grimrock. I was going to say, today we've got light-related puzzles that are going to be a pain in the tuchus. But we will ideally persevere. Is this going to get me? Yes, it is. Alright. Here, I want to mark where we can't go. We can actually just... How do you right-click? There we go. We can just leave them blank. Blank works. Okay, we can come here. But that will teleport us. Okay. This will teleport us. This will teleport us. Of darkness. We might need that actually to proceed through this. That thought had occurred to me. Okay, so I'm positive that that'll teleport us. I'm unsure about this. Okay, this is good. I would bet money that that will teleport us. Okay, we're good to here. So I figure one more step will. Yeah, okay. This is like, I don't know, mildly irksome, just because it's like a time sink. I mean, it fits, but I don't know. Okay, so I figure we probably can't walk that way. There's a teleporter. So not there, not there. Okay, all right. There have been some some secrets and stuff pointed out to me in comments that I missed. That actually might have been one right there. I apologize. Normally I'm pretty good about making notes about that stuff before I record. However, I am recording this immediately after my Sunday stream, so I don't really have... Where am I? Alright, we're in a new area. You shit. I didn't, take any notes like I usually do, because it's late and I need to be going to bed. But I also need to record. Alright, some mole jerky. A couple throwing axes. A crossbow quarrel. I also, the thought occurred to me, that statue looks kind of bad, if I'm being honest. The thought occurred to me that, Bug, we have this spear in his offhand. He has his old wand that gave him 5 energy. I could have him use that in his offhand to get a little bit of extra mana. I'm not going to, because I actually like that he kind of has some ability to defend himself, but I am cognizant that that is something that I could do. Okay, so this teleports us as well. Shit. But no, ideally, like, long-term, what we'll probably do is he'll end up with the... this staff that he's got now, the shaman staff or whatever it's called, and the fire. I think it's an orb that the fire mages get later in. Okay, so my assumption is that we cannot walk here. So I am going to block that, delete that one. Okay. Alright, that's a no-go. That's a portal. We do have this room up here. We can go check that out. Wonder if those fire elementals have respawned, if they respawn. Not looking like it? I'll take it. Oh, we do have an ooze, though. That thing just, like, blopping around. Alright, if you want to just hang out back there, that is fine. We have a teleport, and we have pits. Is there... There's not a button on the wall over there. I was thinking perhaps we threw something... Although, let's see where this takes us. Alright, that's straightforward enough. Just right to the other side. And there's a door. With nothing on the other side immediately. Alright, quick save. What's down the holes? Oh no. Nope. We'll just go away. This is exploratory run here. Are these the chitin boots? Boots of Valor. Plus 15 protection, fashioned of almost impenetrable metal, lighter to wear than the fine steel sabatons of the royal regiments. So I know what they want me to do. Like, I'm expected to, like, weave through this and avoid these, like this. But holy shit. I don't know what I'm supposed to do to open these. There's probably, like, a pressure plate in here that opens them. Let's see if we can find it before we reload. No. No. Might be a hidden button or something. Game over. I think that's our first actual game over. Alright. So we're gonna eat this one. It's okay, that's a lot of damage. I'm gonna take a moment to just look. It's like, this isn't necessarily so much valor, we could just sit here and heal as we approach. Oh, there's a lever. Ha ha! Okay, so that's an upgrade for her, these ring boots. Oh, seriously? Get out of here! I'm evaluating equipment. Have you learned nothing from my ignoring of the blobs? Ah, shit. Oh, they're smart enough to strafe. This is bad. Or maybe they're not. Oh, this is bad. Yep. I was not expecting there to be giant enemy crabs. Crabs are a problem. That's not who I meant to heal. You are who I meant to heal. Okay, we can kill this thing. It's just gonna be a little bit of work. Idea. No, come over here. Go over there. No, goddammit. I have plans for you! Stop strafing! Ah, shit. We're good! Oh, there's goodies in here. No, there's not. I was hopeful. You gonna teleport? No, you're not. I am. Woo! That was nasty! Thankfully, there's a life crystal, like, right here. That was an interesting little murder room. The crabs at the end, like, that was unexpected. I was not thinking that they were gonna throw something that nasty at me after dodging all those traps. I dig it. Okay. A lot of levers. So theoretically, I have an idea. Yeah. Oh, there's something over there. Gotta wait. Fuck, I missed it. Brace of Fortitude. Plus one strength, health regen, food consumption up, though. This is actually... I don't think this is great compared to everything else that we've got, honestly. Alright, what's down the hole? Oh, and we have another troll or ogre, I think. So I've been told that when we hit something and it does zero damage, that's essentially because their resistances are so good, like they're resistant to our attacks. Seriously, guy? There we go. Come on. Oh, he went down. Another ogre hammer that I don't particularly care about. A milk reed. Grim cap. We have stairs up. Spiders. The spiders. Where'd that thing even come from? Was it seriously just like camping here that entire time? Huh. Yeah, nothing. Oh! Heavy shield. Another heavy shield. Evasion 10. How does that compare to his buckler? That is an upgrade. Alright. So, as per protocol, it has been worth falling down the hole. Okay. Almost. I hear something moving. No idea. Just checking for buttons. Not seeing any. Okay. Back up. Where are we? Ah, convenience. I have to say that I like that when you like fall down a hole, they either just teleport you back to like right next to the puzzle, or you take a flight of stairs and it's right back at the puzzle. They're not making me run through like large chunks of the dungeon to get back to these puzzles. Okay. So now I'm looking for buttons. Ah. There we go. Whoa! That's a big ol' nope sandwich right there. Okay, now this is a come at me bro sandwich, but they need to come after me in melee. Come on, you shits! Alright, come on. Let's do this. Got resistance to your attacks. I've come around on fire shield, I hate to admit it. It is less than useful in Dungeon Master, but it's quite handy here. Well, it was situationally useful in Dungeon Master 2. Dungeon Master as well, not specifically Dungeon Master 2. Okay, I can't whinge too much. This also might be a short episode. I'm probably going to end this when we find the exit to the level, so I'm sure there will be salt in the comments about that, but tough. I've got to rein myself in a little bit with recordings here, because work is bad, essentially. There will be a channel update eventually about what is going on. But yeah, this is not the time nor the place. This is for dungeon crawling and heroism. We still actually haven't found the gold key on this level, now that I think about it. So if we find the stairs down, that doesn't necessarily mean we're going to leave. This feels like a fucking trap. Ah! Jesus Christ. Seriously now, guy? Seriously. Even without it, we're still pretty fucking resistant to your bullshit. Bug, heal yourself. Oh, God damn it. Brunhilda! I'm so disappointed in you. You'd be missing out on experience points for days. Ooh, a flail. Oh, there's her new weapon. Holy crap, to 25 attack power. 36? Yeah, she's catching up with Moo now, and we can afford to lose the Warhammer from 18 attack and 11 speed on that to 25 attack and 10 speed on the flail, and she's losing some accuracy, which kind of sucks butt a little bit. I guess we're going to go ahead and backtrack for the life crystal. It's a bit of a hike. It's mostly only obnoxious because we have to go through that room with the dang... this room right here with these freaking pits. Like, this just makes me wait. Not horrible or anything, it's just... Oh, there's apparently also a passage there. And we have all this that I don't even want to know. We have more work to do here. If I had to guess, we will probably make it to half an hour for this episode. That one took us to a different place. Alright. We have a sack with some blood drop things, and a flask, most importantly. Very nice. I'll take it. Actually, go ahead and brew some health potions really quick. Through this terribly kludgy interface. Is this the mana? Yes. So 3 energy and 6 healing potions. Reminds me of... I think it was Dark Souls 3, wasn't it? Where you had to choose between your Estus flasks and the mana flasks. Which I actually thought was kind of a cool thing. Okay, do we have any buttons? Because I don't trust the game not to put buttons back here. And did this take me all the way? Yeah, okay. That's kind of clever. I was wondering how we were expected to get to the other side of that. Just, oh shit. Nope. We want to go this way. Okay. And the life crystals, actually. Actually, no, I think we wanted to go past that slime. I just can't. Oh no, we can go either way. Jesus Christ. Oh, I am so tired. There we go. All right. How's she looking? She might actually be okay. Yeah, she's okay on XP, because with this necklace, she's more or less going to pull ahead. We're actually going to swap it back to Bug, I think. He's only like 1,000 experience points behind, but damn it, every experience point counts. Okay. So before we go too much further, let's check some of these side passages we have. We have all these levers. Oh, that's our torch going out. I was like, why did the lighting just change? All right. What? I have no idea what that just did, but it clicked. So I'm not gonna touch anything else. And we're just gonna leave that alone. I'll leave a note on the map. Alright. Two damage with that spear. I wish the game had more support for pole arms in it, honestly. Like, I think I mentioned early on that it would be cool, I think, if that's like kind of just how mages fought. You give the guy in the back row with the spellbook a spear and let him stab fuckers in the face while the rest of the party's beating on them with, like, flails and shit. That accuracy penalty is hurting Brunhilda, I think. It is an accuracy of 14. Well, it's actually not that much worse. 14 compared to 19. All right, so I can just open it. Another skull. There you go, Moo. Further brutality. That's three. I think there are five in total. Oh. All right. Oh. What? Do I have to stay in the front? No. Oh, do I have to block it? Oh, I've got to just intercept these things, don't I? And maybe eventually that thing will open. Okay. Yeah. Fuck you, game. People say I'm bad at video games. Alright, and we finally found our chitin boots, which is an upgrade straight up over these lurker boots. The evasion loss is kind of pain, but it's okay. See what's a point of dex doing for you. Accuracy and evasion? Losing a point of accuracy. I think I'm actually gonna keep him with the ones he has on. And he can keep his cold resistance. And what is this? A scroll of enchant fire arrow for all those ranged things that I do. And what is down the hole? What is in the hole? Nothing. Fair enough. No buttons. No buttons. Game be trolling. All right, I mean, we still have a little chunk of dungeon to explore. Have we even seen? Yeah, okay, no, we didn't see a gold key door. There is this door down here that I still don't know how to open, unless that's what those levers did. I don't even know. I don't even want to think about it, if I'm being completely honest. Paranoia save. Crap. That's no fun. I'll take this torch. Okay. Well, that wasn't too terrible, I suppose. I wouldn't mind a life crystal, like, closer here so that I didn't have to trek all the way back. But, I'm okay with this, so I think I'm going to go ahead and call it here. So, as per usual, folks, thank you for watching. I hope you all had a good time. And I will see you all next time. We're in probably a proper length episode. Until then.